with some wings. Yeah, put my dick in your bitch, please. Yeah,
rest. Welcome, Joe Byron. Who's Joe Byron? You, Joe Byron. Not me. You. So, things happening. Bought another car. Another project, I guess you could say. So, done got this car right here on the other side of the camera. That's where you are. You're on this side. I'm on that side looking at what you're going to see here in a second. So, yeah. Got this car. Look at it.
Boom.
1998 Lincoln Town Car, baby. And I know what you're thinking. Why the fucking Chocolate City did you buy this shit, right? I'm going to tell you right now. This is a bad bitch right here, all right? I even got the trunk pop. Hold on. Let me just... You know what I mean? Okay. Sup. So it's my 98 Lincoln Town Car. You know what I'm saying? Nothing fancy, just regular. Got that, unfortunately, that dove gray interior, which is nice, but it's harder to find dove gray parts, which I'm finding out now, of course. And, but I mean, overall, car's in nice shape. Boom, and you know, headliner falling, know what I'm saying? But we out here in them streets. So, why the fuck did I buy this car? Good question. Who bought this car? Also good question. Where did I buy this car? Another good question. What did I buy this car with? Also good question. I bought this car with money. I bought this car really far away. Had to get the transporter. Homie motherfucking Austin had to hook that shit up. What else I done did was, they say who, what, when, where, why, and how. Oh yeah, how did I buy this car? Okay, I bought the car with money. I said that before. Anyways, yeah. I bought this car because I want to build a fucking lowrider. Been wanting to build a lowrider since I was 13 years old, and I always thought that I would get into doing lowriders and not the current car path I'm on now. You know what I'm saying? First Fast and the Furious changed that shit up for me when I was younger. Cause I'm like, oh man, I'm gonna build a lowrider, it's gonna be sick. You know what I'm saying? That's it. And fucking Fast and the Furious came out, and I like put lowriders almost out of my head. Always had a love for them, always wanted to build one, and today, here, right fucking now, it starts with this car. You know what I'm saying? So, to give you more perspective on why I chose the Lincoln, I'm gonna tell you right now, the baby, watch. All right, so the reason I went with the Lincoln, right? I could go with any car, and I had a list of cars I was going with. The list of cars that I had were like a 96 Cadillac Fleetwood, like an 87 Cutlass. Really wanted one of those, actually. This car, and you know, at the very top of my list, which is unaffordable, 62 to 63 two-door hardtop Impala. You know what I'm saying? So I had to narrow all my choices down. I had to be realistic about it, right? I'm fucking old. I ain't young like you motherfuckers, right? So I had to say to myself, realistically, what can I buy and why? So I like the town cars. I think they look sick as lowriders. It's a more modern car, right? At the top of my list is obviously the Impalas, but those are unobtainable cars for me at this time. So those are first thing off the list. I like the Cutlass, but I had an 87 Buick Regal and, 86 Buick Regal. And that Regal had a 3-speed transmission in it, and on the highway doing like maybe 70, the motor's fucking screaming. And I wanna drive a loader on the highway so I can go to and from work and shit. You know what I'm saying? I wanna not be limited to where I can go with my vehicles. None of my cars are limited, they go everywhere, right? So then I'm like, all right, I wanted the Cadillac Fleetwood. Now, Fleetwood's a big badass car. However, that body style was only made for like 4 or 5 years total. So parts and everything for them, chassis wise, super fucking limited, right? The Lincoln. This one right here. The Lincoln, on the other hand, is the same car as the Crown Vic and the Grand Marquis. So it's literally like the bodies are different, but the same frame, same engine, same tranny. That same 4.6 liter V8 that's in this Lincoln is in those other cars. It's in Ford's SUVs and their trucks. These fucking motors are dime a dozen for everywhere for like a 15 year, from like 98 to like 2012 or some shit. Like, they go on for fucking ever. You know what I'm saying? So I said to myself, I said what I had said was, I said, self, so what's up, baby? Then I said, you like air conditioning. I said, as a matter of fact, I do, baby. Let me hold down a little bit of AC, please. And then this car got the AC, babe. Boom. You know what I'm saying? So long story short, I didn't want to buy a car that I had to start with building to make it work, right? I wanted a car that I start with that already works, right? And not only that, but if I need to go to the parts store, I can buy any part for this engine, period. Anything. Condensers, power steering pumps, alternators. They made them for so fucking long, like the LS engine, that I can fucking buy this shit at any parts store all over the fucking place, right? Different things are gonna be, you know what I'm saying, a little different, like in here, if like the switches go bad for like the, you know, windows or like the seats and shit, which actually the seat is, this front is stuck upwards and won't go down. But like if I want to, you know, do anything related with pretty much anything, like they have like the same dashboards even, you know what I'm saying? So like if I need any parts for these cars, window regulators, door locks, all the random bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Like all that shit is literally dime a fucking dozen. They are fucking everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm 90% sure these are still the same seats, if not even almost the same interior as the Grand Marquis and as the Crown Vic. You know what I mean? Cause I used to have an 01 Grand Marquis back in the day, like many years ago. So I wanted a car that was easy for me to start at, right? I don't want a car where I have to start by fixing it, doing work to it, doing all this little bullshit. I want to start with a platform where I can already put cool shit on the car and go forward. Feel me?
Feel me?
Anyways, so with that, I chose the fucking Lincoln. And I almost bought a, '96 fucking Fleetwood, but I got talked out of it, so, which is not a bad thing because like I said, the Lincoln just makes more choice. The Caddy would have been hands down a cooler car to have, period, right? But these Lincolns are fucking cool cars. I can't, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm more familiar with these chassis, you know what I'm saying? So like, yeah, here we are. So with that being said, I ordered me a gold-plated steering wheel that's faded. So now it's chrome steering wheel. Now it's a chrome, gnarly wood grain steering wheel instead of a gold one. No big deal. That's tight. The wood was in good shape. That's kind of why I bought it. I bought the steering wheel adapter. Tight, you know what I'm saying? What else I had them bought was, oh yeah, the most important thing, I bought wheels. I bought motherfucking Hunter Spoke reverse knockoffs, you know what I'm saying? But they were supposed to show up. See, when I had bought them, they should have had shipped out on Monday. I should have had got them Friday. This is the following week, Tuesday. Still ain't fucking got these wheels yet, you know what I'm saying? It's supposed to be delivered today, but now it's the latest fucking today, which sucks because I was actually gonna work on this, but I've been fucking around getting the whole, I had to clean up the go-kart from the zone, clean my whole zone. I was doing some welding with this on this. This video might be before or after this. I don't know, so you'll see anyways. But yeah, had to clean up my whole zone here, reorganize all my shit. Had to put the go-kart back over here where it belongs, you know what I'm saying? Clean up my whole zone. Clean up my whole zone, which isn't even finished being cleaned because like I got a, you know, trash pile here, you know what I'm saying? However, it really sucks because as wheels, I was like super fucking pumped on that. Now, cool things about this car and the Grand Marquis is they had air suspension in the rear. Most of them did, but not all the cars had them. Some cars had springs. That's if you got the more base model. Now, the popular thing to do was, because all the airbags and all these cars always went out eventually, is they just took the airbags out and put Crown Vic springs back in them because they're fucking like 80 bucks, cheap as fuck. You know, you put two of them in there, right? So that's exactly what happened to this car. This car was an airbag car. They put springs in it. And as, I mean, I kind of wish the airbags were working in here, but you know what I'm saying? Hold on, let me kick this. I'm trying to do you wrong, baby. Come on now, hold up. Let's come over here. Let's get this. Let me show you something around here. Yeah, I don't know why I just walked all the way around the car, but we live, baby, we live. All right, so, oh, fucking bitch. Don't get old, it sucks. All right. Oh yeah, you can't see a fucking thing, can you? All right.
Hold up.
All right, here we go. There we go. Now you get the idea. Where this spring sat is where the aero suspension was supposed to be. So it's a good thing and a bad thing for me because, come on now. Good thing and a bad thing for me because with the air suspension, I could have just added a dump valve to it and then I could have just pulled up and let it out. And then the factory air pump, I could just put it on a kill switch so I could turn it on so it pumped the bags back up enough to lift the car up and go driving or whatever. And then, however, the advantage to the springs is I can just cut them shits. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna cut them shits. So throwing wheels in the car ain't shit. Cutting the springs is shit because I don't know how much to cut because I need the fucking wheels in the damn car. You know what I mean? So another reason why I like this car, since you're here, let me show you. Hold up, hold up. No gas tank back here because the gas tank is up there somewhere on underneath the back seat, right? So with this, I can put fucking drag blocks in the back corners of this fucking frame and I can dump the car on the ground and I can drag fucking shit and shoot sparks, which is pretty cool. That's a cool thing that like mini truckers used to do. And like coming up, like lowriders wouldn't do it as often as usually cars that had bags on them. So it was always cool to me to see that. You know what I'm saying? My dog's barking for no reason as usual. But yeah, so that's where we're at. And in this video, you're gonna see me put some wheels on this car and cut some springs up, do some things, little baby. So stay motherfucking tuned and watch this shit. The video could be a little bit long, but you know, that's what it takes around here, little baby. Boom, peep this shit.
Get it? Text a message, I don't know the number. Flexing on these niggas, every bone and muscle. Steady taking shots, never hurting them. Even then, y'all don't worry nothing. And I like to give a shout out to my niggas with the game plan. And shout outs on my niggas with escape plans. 20 bands, rain dance. We can eat the rain check or we can make plans. Pockets loaded, rocket loaded, can't let's rock and roll this. Time to go, lock, stock, and two smoking barrels locked and loaded. Diamonds glowing, chop, climbing on them. We think I'm jumping out the window, how I got them open. Line around the corner, line them up the block and over. Sometimes I even stop the smoking when it's time to focus. My shade, Dior, my pants, velour. Create, explore, expand, concord. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I praise the Lord, then break the law. I take what's mine, then take some more. It rains, it pours, it rains, it pours. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I praise the Lord, then break the law. I take what's mine, then take some more. It rains, it pours, it rains, it pours. Yeah, I sold the pack, the loose, the hard. Yeah, I listen to X, I beat the bars. Yeah, the snakes, the rats, the cats, the dogs, the games, a trap. Protect your heart, yeah. Awaited in line. Return, refine the new design. It's time to shine, to shine, to shine, to shine, to shine. I hustle, I flex, the world is mine. So please believe, allow the grease. These niggas, disease, don't speak, we squeeze. I make the devil go weak, the knees. You hate, you're lame, you're lost. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I praise the Lord and break the law. I take what's mine and take some more. It rains, it pours, it rains, it pours. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I praise the Lord and break the law. I take what's mine and take some more. It rains, it pours, it rains, it pours.
She came, I came, now what's my name? My chain, my pants with the chain. They know it's me, the hot
your phone number.
Gangsters in the house.
Long phone.
Get money. New money.
This must have been waiting on.
Hey.
Rich boy, sell it quick. Folk niggas wanna jet. Shit tight, no stick. Just bought a Cadillac.
Put some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac.
Put some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy, sell it quick. Folk niggas wanna jet. Shit tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac.
Put some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy, sell it quick. Folk niggas wanna jet. Shit tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac. Took it to the top, top, got the damn top drop. Two color flip flop in the red lollipop.
This house in the parking lot.
But I still got my Glock cock. New money, motherfucker. Don't you see the big dot? Don't you see the big chain? Don't you see the big grill? Wonder who they hating on lately, baby. This hill. Candy paint, gated skin seats. Call me Dundee. Hoping you hood, I'm the one that you wanna be. Haters wish they could feel the wood in my 83. Ride with no tits, so the motherfucker knows me. Rich boy, sell it quick. Folk niggas wanna jack. Shit tight, no snack. Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy, sell it quick. Folk niggas wanna jack. Shit tight, no snack. Just bought a Cadillac.
Alright, so it's been a few days since been a few days since I put the Lowrider together. So far, so good, right? Car drives pretty good, it's smooth, it's clean, drove it to work. It survived the highway test. You know what I'm saying? I mean, a big body car and little small ass tires and wheels, you know what I'm saying? It's definitely got a little swing to it, you know what I mean? But to get the back of the car low, I had to, I tried my girl's MK5 Supra rear springs first because they were like 5 or 6 inches shorter than the stock springs that were on the car. And I figured, okay, well, with 5-inch drop, relatively 5-inch drop, it's not exactly how it works. But I figured, all right, potentially 5-inch drop plus springs that's meant to be on a car that weighs 3,200 pounds, not 4,000. I'm like, all right, the back going to squash. You know what I'm saying? No, little baby, no. These not the cases. The motherfucking spring rate is so serious in the back of that fucking Supra. Probably the reason why I fucking took the car out, went coilovers in that car because the suspension's too stiff. The springs were so stiff that the back of the car would hit bumps and bounce upwards and shoot the back up. So the car didn't squat. It just made the car sit from this to level. You know what I'm saying? Like stock springs push the back of the car up to accommodate for extra weight between like shit in the trunk and then people sitting in the back seats. And the super springs really just made the car level and not drive good at all. So then I spent more time trying to figure out maybe I should just strap chains in the rear end and crush the springs or torture them and do all kinds of shit. And I'm just like, yeah, I can't be fucking destroying my girl's MK5 springs. You know what I'm saying? Like, so I decided look around the house, see what I had. And it just so happened that I had my original black S13 rear coilover springs chilling because I had the original shocks from when I first put the car together, and the rear shocks were fucked up. And I had the springs, which are half the height of the stock Lincoln spring, and it fits enough. So that's how I got the car to be a little bit lower in the back. So that's pretty tight. But the car, that 6K spring, the car floats, it rolls, suspension's pretty even as far as like spring rate goes and like the shocks go. So the car floats for the most part, it's pretty comfortable. Couple bounties here and there, you know what I'm saying, whatever. But overall, the car is tight. Hopefully get some chrome tint on it. I have a new steering wheel adapter coming at some point so I can throw a fucking Nardi in there. I got a faded gold wood grain Nardi for the car, which is pretty cool. Essentially it's just like painted gold on top of chrome, you know what I mean? So or like whatever coating they use, you know what I'm saying? So it's pretty tight. I'm enjoying the car. I'm pretty excited that, you know, since I was 13 years old I wanted to fucking do a Lowrider, and now I finally got to the point where I could at least put my foot in the door, you know what I'm saying? Hopefully the end of this year I can put hydraulics on it, which is not too expensive, but also workload wise very high considering what it takes to put them on. So we'll see how that goes. You know what I'm saying? You already know how it is, a baby. So yeah, enjoy some things, see some things. Got more videos coming as always. And then yeah, I think that's it. You know what I'm saying? I'll talk to you later, little babe. We're gonna do some more R32 things, because that car is spent a lot of money in that car. I'm still waiting on parts for that car too now, of course. So yeah, boom, little baby. And that's all I got for you today. So if you got a Lowrider and you're in my area, maybe we can drive around together or something. I don't know. Holler at your boy. Peace.
My crew robs every fag that walks through with gold on. I cruise slow with the gun on my lap, so keep running your trap and I'll put one in your cap. Got mad places to go, buying cases of mo. Why you doing capers for dough? Cause your papers is low. What?
Yo, this is how we do it, Harlem NYC.